Assalamu alaikum, habibati, and welcome to another Arab Man Reacts. This might be my first ever reaction to a Slipknot song, because I can't remember. I know I've done a lot of Corey Taylor. I know Corey Taylor from Stone Sour. I know that because the songs Bother and Through the Glass are two of the songs that I perform all the time. In fact, Through the Glass sort of became my and my band's signature song at all the concerts that we played. But I've never really expanded my listening to other Stone Sour songs, except the stuff that I've reacted to on the channel. And I absolutely have never gotten into Slipknot. So this is Psychosocial, live from Day of the Gusano. And we're just gonna get right into it. Remember to like, comment, subscribe, turn on the bell notification, support us if you want to by leaving a super thanks down below if the video allows it, or by joining us over on Patreon, link in the description below. Over on Patreon, you get access to all of our blocked videos, and we get to have some cool conversations, and sometimes we vlog. Oh, so many people! I think the biggest crowd we've ever played to is probably, I want to say 5,000, maybe 10,000 when we did those big festivals. Or like AUB Outdoors, which was this crazy event that our university used to put together once a year. We'd actually organize it as part of the music club. But that's a lot of people. Jesus. Beautiful human being. What a voice. All right, I love this scene. It's a good place to pause. So I already know that Slipknot, you know, they get in character, they put on a show, they do all this, but I've never really watched the show, and I think it's really cool to see some of the elements that they're putting together there. Like the clown guy just sitting there and bumping the barrels, like I think that has to be like the most comedy relief thing I've ever seen in my life in a freaking metal show where everyone's dressed in like, I don't know, filthy dark apocalyptic zombies. Like, I don't know how to explain it. But there's some really cool decisions being made there. Like, I see what looks like over here. Where is it? That looks like a keg, right? On the left over there. And I wonder if it's actually mic'd up and he's actually playing the keg, or the keg is just something that they're putting on top of like a drum. But I mean, even those two drums right there have to be some of the biggest drums I've ever seen. So they're probably not drums either. They're probably something that they put together, which is really cool, because if they're actually playing that stuff, it means that they're sort of creating their own instruments for the show, which is something that I think we should all appreciate. Just beautiful everything on the stage. Honestly, dude, look at that. That is a gorgeous setup for a stage. And there's two drum sets, now I'm realizing. One played by our friendly clown. That's so fucking heavy, dude. Very audio slavey guitar bit there. There's a dancer on the stage.
Oh. another murder in me.
Wow, wow, wow. Yo, those are some of the tastiest solos. Wait. So many cool things have happened here. I gotta say this right here. The wah, 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 wah. That break, dude, the decision to go with that kind of sound right there. It completely breaks through all the filth that we're listening to. Once that comes in, great decision making on that sound. And then his vocals come in and just elevate the entire thing, right? Completely changing like the dynamic of the song. I guess that's what Slipknot are known for, right? Like, it turns from filth to beauty, you know? Those solos. Yeah. Are you listening to all those little things? All those? Wow. It looks like he's getting tired. Oh, trotting along. I'm tired. Dear Tayyip is solo. Dear Tayyip is solo. I thought it was an actual torch at the beginning, but no, it's just fireworks. Oh my God. Yo, that was fucking beautiful. Oh my God. Unbelievable. Gets me to Emmy. Oh my God, come on guys, come on. Wait for it. I really want to know what the DJ was doing there. He's literally scratching his own. He's doing all the scratches there. But he's just going back and forth very quickly between two audio tracks that he probably preloaded. And that's giving that little like sound effect there. Like that. Making creative decisions like that just amplify everything that you're listening to so much more. That's so heavy, dude. It's the f-ing heaviest thing in this dude right here. Like, I wanna be best friends with this guy. Ramsey has a fear of clowns, a morbid fear of clowns. So I have no idea, Ramsey, when you're about to edit this, I know you're gonna be terrified. Hey, he's a happy clown. Like, yeah, let's go. Wow. All right. Just observations. Obviously, I know Stone Sour, so I'm not going to talk anything about Corey Taylor. I love Corey Taylor. He's one of my favorite singers of all time on this earth. I was never a fan before of this kind of singing. I was never into metal. And I slowly, over the past year or so, started to just fall more and more in love with metal and really with just that feshet khilit that you get from listening to metal and that part right before the ending, dude, that grueling, disgusting, filthy part. If you really pay attention, listen to it, you can clearly tell apart all the different musical instruments coming into this thing, filling it up. So it doesn't sound like a mess. It sounds as filthy and disgusting as it is. You can tell apart all the different instruments, dude. It's mixed so well. Nothing is overtaking anything else. It's just, it's not just heavy, it's artistic, it's also, in a way, I don't know, scientific, the way they just layered it up and put it together. It's a freaking phenomenal piece of music. And I think now I sort of understand a little bit more, or a lot more, what the satisfaction is from listening to Slipknot. And I'm sort of happy that I'm finally there, because I was like, no, never Slipknot, I don't want to listen to that. You know, that was obviously before I really got into metal. But now it's like, I need that. Like, I will listen to this entire song over just to get to that part. I know exactly what I'm going to be doing, because I do this all the time. I'm in the car, I'm driving down the highway, I'm on my way to work, and I will time it so that when that part comes up, I'm getting into the parking of the office building that I work for, and I'm blasting the music with my windows down just a little bit, just so everybody listening knows that that's what I'm listening to, right? Call it whatever you want to call it, but that's exactly what I do, and that's exactly what I'm going to do come Monday morning in the office, or on my way to the office. Maybe I'll make a video. Oh, that was such a feshet khilit. Technical abilities off the freaking charts. Fantastic show, phenomenal musicianship, amazing creative everything. They're artists, dude. They're technical beasts. They're beautiful. I love them. And I think this might just be the beginning of my Slipknot journey. Thank you so much for watching Pep Konektir. I will catch you in the next one. Remember to like, comment, subscribe, turn on the bell notification. Support us if you want to by leaving a super thanks down below or by joining us over on Patreon, link in the description below. Salamat.